I also wanted to talk about the thin line between complex generics and the 505B2 applications. I know. I'm wondering what happened here. It looked better in the computer. So, when is a 505B2 viable alternative to an ANDA? So, we are seeing that a lot of people have started thinking of 505B2 as an alternative to ANDAs. The reason is because the generic market has become super competitive. And the way things are going, if you are not the first or second company to get the drug approved, you hardly make any profit. So people have started thinking, could we go to a 505B2 and then get an authorized generic? When is it a viable alternative? So, reformulation of the product to address, maybe a different route of administration, different population. Use of a different salt, as I said, we are seeing that quite often. Overcome, the formulation design, especially the Q1, Q2. This is one of the biggest fields where we have seen, even in FDA and out here in PAREXEL, where people have gone into the 505B2, because the Q1, Q2, being a quantitatively and qualitatively similar to the innovator product, sometimes is becoming very difficult because of patent challenges and other issues. And they, as I was just explaining, that they might say that we can make a better formulation. Drug-device combinations, this is also one of the fields, as we said, we see that especially with the inhalation products, we are seeing this a lot. Because many of these devices are heavily patented, and it's extremely difficult to get around the patent. So people are saying, why don't I go for a 505B2? Complex peptides, which are DNA sourced and include potential immunogenicity concerns. This is kind of a very gray area, but we are seeing this. As I was saying, with many, many of the complex generics, FDA came and told the world that we are opening our doors. They approved salmon, calcitonin, glatiramer, heparin, low molecular weight heparin. And that gave the industry an impression that, okay, the doors are open and OGD is ready to look at complex generics. But appears that they are kind of pulling themselves back on this, and they are saying that if a peptide is synthetic, we are going to look at it, but the moment it is an rDNA source, there may be immunogenicity concerns, which technically become safety concerns, so we are going to send them for 505B2, and this has become a very gray area, because the question is, many of these formulations are Q1, Q2, so how and where they will fit is still to be seen, but this is one issue that's coming. The 505B2 may help subverting some patent challenge. The word is some here, because even if you're anything remotely close to the innovator, you will get sued here. A branded generic, now the word branded generic is a term that we used to use in FDA. This is a 505B2, but as I was saying, if you make a better formulation, like for example, exactly what I was saying, that the innovator is a lyophilized powder in one bottle and a buffer, it has to be mixed and then it has to be given to the reconstituted in saline and then given. Instead, if you can find a way to stabilize that solution and you're bringing, it's exactly the same strength and everything. It may not be Q1, Q2 at the end of the day, but once reconstituted, it's more or less the same product. So it's for all purposes a generic, but technically can't be approved as a generic. Many of these get a 505B2 and then appeal and get what you call the AP or the AB rating, mostly AP because it's parenteral. We see this a lot in parenterals. Not an easy pathway, but we are seeing this a lot. So why can 505B2 be more appealing? Obviously, you're getting a three-year marketing exclusivity. Depending on the nature of the 505B2 submission, you know, minimal amount of submission studies, we have had situations where really, you know, hardly any kind of study or work was needed other than CMC. Lesser approval time than generics. This is supposed to improve by with GDUFA 2, because with GDUFA 1 had created such a quagmire that it was taking 36 to 40 months for generics to be approved. So B2s became good options. Fast track approval can be, GDUFA doesn't deal with orphan products. They do not give any kind of priority, but 505B2 will. Better communication with FDA, several meetings can be, or at least very, you know, poignant written responses. Their written response, their communication is much more detailed, and you get really good advice. Negotiation with FDA regarding studies, less competition sometimes, you know, based on the nature of the product that you're bringing out, and higher return on investment. Now, obviously, the last two could vary big time. What are the challenges? Now, remember that 505B2 is an NDA. It is, nothing is assumed there. So the fee for the NDA, you know, are significantly higher. You know, GDUFA is like, what, 73,000 now? And this is 600 plus thousand. Generic companies need to carefully, evaluate. So not to jump into this, you know, and say, let's just do it. Put a little thought on this. So as we say, the standard for demonstration of safety and efficacy is for NDAs are same, and 505B2 is an NDA. Significant studies, including expensive clinical trials, may be required. The CMC requirement for 505B2 can sometimes be different. You know, many things, example, of course, this is probably the minimal. Like, they need 12 months long-term stability versus 6 months for generics. But we have also seen, regarding excipients, a lot of things are assumed in the Office of Generic Drug. But when you go to the new drug, you have to be careful. So they also have to have a good idea of what currently marketed products, you know, and strategize, because with generic, the thought process, there isn't a lot of thought other than maybe how am I going to break the patent involved. But here, you need to really strategize. So please remember that 505B2 is not a glorified ANDA. There needs to be study of several candidates, study of the market demands, you know, and the risks and roadblocks. And we can't stress this enough. Please, if you are planning a 505B2, even if it's at a conception stage, go for a meeting.